Welcome to JC's Stocks and Markets Podcast for July 29th, 2023. I'm JC. I've been investing in the stock market for 40 plus years. My intentions with these podcasts are to share my thoughts and opinions on some stocks and ETF picks with an emphasis on dividend paying securities. I just want to share investment ideas so that you and I can maybe make a buck. Not doing this to make money from anyone in any way. The opinions here are shared on my own. They're just that, opinions. I invest in many of the stocks and ETFs that are featured in these podcasts, including the one that we're going to look at today. The disclaimer, do your due diligence before investing in anything. With that, hey, let's go make some money. The stock we're going to look at today is NNN REIT. They invest in primarily high-quality retail properties throughout the United States. As of March, the end of March, they owned about 3,500 properties in 49 states and a gross leasable area of about 35 million square feet. The weighted average remaining lease term is 10.3 years, which is pretty high in the business. NNN is one of the three publicly traded REITs to have increased their annual dividends for 33 or more consecutive years, and that's pretty substantial. One of the reasons that I own this NNN, and it's NNN on the New York Stock Exchange. NNN REIT, here's some basic information on NNN. Market cap's about $8 billion, PE ratio's 22, which is, you know, it's higher than most, let's say, stocks that I own. But it's not too bad considering the rest of the REITs out there. The earnings per share, $1.93, just about covered the forward yield, dividend I should say, $2.26. Yield's about 5%, and again, they've been growing the dividends for 33 consecutive years, which is pretty outstanding. Now I know that REITs, and especially with commercial properties, people are a little scared of those leases and those financings of those properties coming due. If you're afraid of that, if you think there's going to be a property or commercial property, let's say, meltdown, this may not be for you. For me, I think these guys own a lot of high-quality properties. They're diversified in healthcare, commercial, and a number of areas. The dividend keeps growing. They've made it through a whole bunch of, let's say, economic issues and crises. Nice company. Revenue estimates are going up. It looks about 5% a year. Looks like the earnings, the current estimates are actually going up for this year and next year. You know, I that's why I like this. It's a good dividend-paying stock, ETF. I should, not ETF, but REIT. And it continues to increase. For me, income generating is what I'm looking for, and that's why I'm in this thing. And I don't see this having problems in the near future. But if you're afraid of commercial properties, by all means, be careful, do your diligence, look at it, but do your own investigation and decision making. Next and last slide that I have is the Argus. It's just from the 26th here. They're raising their target price to 49. Essentially, NNN has been down a little bit this year, which is fine. You know, I've been collecting dividends as it's been going down, and I'm continuing to plow those back into NNN. The real estate sector, you know, it's kind of iffy, but it says here, the REIT shares have recently faced pressure from rising interest rates. We see longer-term benefits of the reopening of offices, and I think that's going to be big. Increased physical retail activity and the benefits to niche retail. REIT plays in medical facilities, apartments, data centers, and other areas. These guys are in the right locations in terms of properties, and that's why I like it. Earnings are growing, dividends are growing. It's getting good ratings from people like Argus and others. Target's about, 12% higher than it is now, maybe a little higher than that. You know, I would consider it. I own it. I'm plowing my dividends back in. I may buy some more because it's dropped down a couple bucks in the past week. With that, I think NNN is probably a pretty good buy here, but do your own due diligence. I appreciate you listening to JC Stocks and Markets podcast. You know, I'm not doing this for revenue. I just like doing this. The intro and outro song is by a band I used to play in, Just One Goat. The song's called She's the One. I wrote it and it has a lot of meaning for me. Hope you enjoy it. I hope you enjoy the podcast. Happy investing. Do your diligence. And we'll see you next time in 2 weeks.
Loving purely physical, but I never have to roam. Well, she's always there for me. It's simple, can't you see? She's the one. Oh, she's the one. Everything is magical, even when she's not around. No, it's not that radical, I just know. There for me, it's simple, can't you see? She's the one, oh, she's the one. She's making my life so much stronger. God, let me stay just a little bit longer. She's the one, yeah, she's the one. All this time.